Very good morning, students. We will continue today with our lesson number 3 and the topic rebellion in the countryside. Like if we talk about the last video, in that the last topic we have discussed was the non-corporation movement in towns. In that topic we have seen who played the main role in towns, that was middle class, and what was the impact of, or we can say consequence of, the non-corporation movement carried on in towns. And the third thing we have seen, the limitation of non-corporation movement. These three subtopics we have covered under that. Now today we are starting from rebellion in the countryside, and the topics today we will cover are rebellion in the countryside, then we will see the role of tribal people, and third topic we will see, that is Swaraj in plantation. One thing here you have to make clear is this: in this topic, rebellion in the countryside, we will talk about the role of peasants in the non-corporation movement, and role of tribal people in this topic. Obviously, we will see what was the role played by the tribal people during the non-corporation movement, and Swaraj in plantations. Here we will see about the condition of workers and how they thought of Swaraj, or what was the meaning of Swaraj to workers. This we will see. Okay, so as in the starting of this topic, or we can say non-corporation movement, it was said that the different group of peoples were having different meanings of Swaraj. Okay, here we will see that in the countryside, or we can say to the peasants, what was the meaning of Swaraj. Here we will see what was the meaning of Swaraj for tribal people, and here we will see what was the meaning of Swaraj for the workers in plantation. Okay, so we are starting with the rebellion in the countryside, or we can say role of peasants in the non-corporation movement. Now at Awadh, or that Awadh was small province of UP, and here Baba Ramchandra was the person who played, or we can say who headed the movement against the talukdars or landlords, because they were imposing higher rents and taxes on the peasants. Okay, talukdars were the people who were controlling the various tehsils, and landlords were the people who are having large amount or big amount of land. Okay, so now what was the problem here? We will see that the peasants were forced for beggar, that was forced labor, and many times they used to work, most of the time they used to work without payment. No salary or wages were given to the peasants for their work, and they were also not having security of tenure. Means these people were working on land, and these people was not having any surety for them, and no right on the leased land. So many times they were evicted, or we can say thrown out. This was the regular practice there. So this is the situation, or the critical part through which the peasants were dealing with. Now if we talk about what kind of demand these peasants were asking for, kya inki demands thi? These peasants were asking for reduction of revenue, the huge amount of tax that was imposed on these peasants. They want that should be brought down. Next demand was abolition of beggar, that was forced food labor that these peasants were doing, that should be abolished. And third thing they want, that was social boycott of oppressive landlords. तीसरी चीज जो ये चाहते थे, ये बिल्कुल socially boycott करना चाहते थे किनको, जो dominating landlords थे, जो इनको परेशान करते थे, ठीक है, उनको. So this was the condition. अब ये इनकी demands जब fulfill नहीं हो रही थी, तो इनके turn में peasants ने क्या step लिया? Peasants ने क्या step लिया वो देखिए. नाई धोबी बंस वर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड, मतलब कि नाई धोबी इज यूज फॉर द वॉशमैन्स एंड नाई फॉर बार्बर्स. सो दीज वर द पीपल हु आर प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसेज टू द लैंडलॉर्ड्स. लैंडलॉर्ड्स को इन चीज़ों की ज़रूरत थी, और इनकी सर्विसेज किसके थ्रू प्रोवाइड की जा रही थी? पीजेंट्स के थ्रू. तो पंचायत ने मिलकर क्या किया कि ये लोग कोई भी सर्विसेज नहीं देंगे, बार्बर सर्विसेज और वॉशरमैन की सर्विसेज किसको? लैंडलॉर्ड्स को, क्योंकि उस टाइम पे अपने बिहाफ पे इन्होंने ये